Adobe Premiere Pro, the video editing giant and industry leader for the last decade, has got some competition. And who would that be?
CapCut.
CapCut has recently reached 200 million active users. That's almost the population of Brazil, man, in comparison to the 9 million users that Premiere Pro has. But this is for the mobile app that has become the most popular editing app out there. But with their recent launch of CapCut Desktop, which is way more powerful than the browser version, Premiere Pro has some serious competition. So in this video, I'm going to edit with both programs to figure out how close the competition actually is. With that being said, so here is the plan. I was recently teaching a young filmmaker how to shoot cars, and I got to shoot this beautiful Ferrari.
Cool car, man. What is that? Ferrari?
So I'm going to make a simple car edit with both softwares, but here are the rules. One, we have to use the same music. Two, we have to use the same footage. Three, the final video must be 15 seconds long. Four, we can't use anything outside the software. That means no After Effects or Premiere Pro, which actually might make this a little bit hard. But five, we both only get 45 minutes to edit the video. Because if you saw my beginner versus pro video, I did 50 minutes and you remember how that turned out.
Oh, hell no, man.
Team CapCut. Team Premiere Pro. Timer starts now.
I'm gonna get the music in.
Okay, I'm gonna just add the beats.
Oh wait, there's a whole AI thing. Let's do that. I mean, the AI did a pretty good job, to be fair. That just saved me some time. Oh, what's actually kind of cool is that if you want to get a selection, you just simply drag it from left to right like this. I can then drag this down and it's already pre-cut. Whereas in Premiere Pro, you have to double click it, put in and out, and then drag it in. You see what I mean? I got to literally double click it, then go through it.
I do like the selection process more in CapCut, I can't lie.
I want this to be speed ramp.
Look at that. So easy.
How do you reverse, dude?
Bro, there's literally a reverse button right here. Okay, so I've had to reverse something here. If you didn't even know you could speed ramp in reverse on Premiere Pro, I teach this in my speed ramping masterclass, which you can check out, link down below. Okay, we got 30 minutes left.
I've only got three clips down because I'm trying to finger out everything.
Let's look at this. Nice.
Oh, you can adjust the speed ramps just like this. Oh my days. More shots, more shots.
So this, I want to keep it in the center. However, I can't use After Effects. I'm going to have to manually track it. Ooh, that looks rough. Okay, we got 16 minutes left. I am not even halfway.
Why is this taking so long?
Man, cropping is so easy. What the hell?
Scale that up. Transform, move it up.
Why do I do this to myself? The panic begins. Bro, what effects do I even add? Because I can't use After Effects. It's not that hard. You know what? I'm going to do some mask transitions.
Oh my gosh.
Look how easy it is to add these shakes. You just go to animation, you find a shake, you click the clip, boom. And it previews it for you. So easy. I only have time to do like color transitions, dude. Oh yeah, we can add my glow effect from that one tutorial.
Make it red.
We got 3 minutes.
Bro, I swear, time constraints just stress me out.
Let's do some random effects, bro. Yeah, boy. Let's add
motion blur.
Oh my days. I don't know if this is gonna work, to be fair. Can't think of anything else to add.
I'm just throwing everything.
I think that's it. I'm just gonna drink my coffee for the last 10 seconds.
Oh shit.
Bro, that was hard. Oh, Jesus. Oh, well, this is what it looks like. Using Premiere Pro for about 8 years now. I can pretty much use the software completely blindfolded.
However, the speed ramps on CapCut was so much easier to do. Even though I know how to use Premiere Pro, I have all the shortcuts, it still took me pretty much just as long as using CapCut when I had to figure things out myself. In Premiere Pro, if you want to reverse something, you just right click, speed duration, reverse. Whereas on CapCut, you just press a button, it reverses it, and then you can just throw in any speed ramp you want, and then you can throw in any effects. If I was much more proficient at CapCut and I knew how to use it properly, I could edit much faster.
But the crazy part is, inside CapCut, you get a lot of features that in Premiere Pro, you have to either get a plugin for or leave to go to After Effects. For example, rotoscoping, motion tracking, shake effects.
Look at all of these pre-made effects for you that on Premiere Pro would take ages to make. There were loads more presets for effects that I could just use straight out the bat, whereas on Premiere Pro, I just don't have that many, to be honest. I usually do all of that stuff in After Effects.
Then again, Premiere Pro has a lot of plugins that you can add on, such as Story Blocks, Frame.io, uploading directly to YouTube, and hundreds of thousands of plugins that have been made by the creator community, which CapCut seems to not really have. So maybe there's something that CapCut can add in the future. I don't know. I'm just a messenger. Something that we need to really talk about is pricing. Now, CapCut is actually free to use anywhere. However, there are some pro features and pro effects that you have to pay for, which at the time of this video is not very expensive, around $10 per month, which in comparison to Premiere Pro's pricing of $20.99 for just the software or for the whole suite being something like $600 a year. But then again, you know, Premiere Pro is targeted at professional video editors in big industries, whereas CapCut is really just for people that want to create for social media, that want to do maybe ads for Facebook and TikTok, which, to be honest, that is where the world is moving right now. As an agency owner, most of my clients come from just doing social media videos, and that's mostly what I do. So whether you agree or not, you gotta agree that CapCut has come a long way from just being a mobile app. By the way, if you want to learn how to do some really cool CapCut effects, you can check out this video here. For Premiere Pro users, if you want to learn how to make some cool Premiere Pro videos, you can check out this video right here. Thank you so much for watching this video. Please hit the subscribe button. I'm so close to 100k. I really want to get there this year, so please help me. With that being said, I'll see you in the next video.